What's up, everybody? I'm Tim from Timber Ridge Gifts. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make your own DIY silicone molds. There's a lot of molds on the market. You can find just about anything you want, but occasionally you're going to run across something that you want to mold that there's just nothing on the market for, so you're going to have to make your own. That's what actually got me started making my own, was I wanted a Fruit Loop mold for embeds for a Fruit Loop candle I was doing. I searched all over the internet, all over Etsy, could only find one. It was probably maybe an 8x11 sheet. They wanted $30 for it. Well, there was no way I was going to do that. So I decided to set out, try to learn how to make my own. I saw a lot of videos online, read a lot of articles. Didn't really like anything I saw. They were either too complicated, they just didn't work, they were too specific, or they weren't specific enough. So I decided to make my own. This is literally going to be the easiest and the cheapest video, or the easiest and the cheapest way of making them that you're going to find on YouTube. So before we get started, you're just going to need a handful of supplies. Let's just go over those real quick. You're going to need just a disposable plastic tub, just something that you can throw away because it's basically going to be ruined. You're not going to be able to use it again. Some popsicle sticks for stirring, a utility knife, a caulking gun, and a rolling pin. That's really all you're going to need. We'll go over the ingredients you're going to need in just a second. Let me take a second to zoom the camera in and show you guys how to get started. Okay, so let's go over the ingredients. You really want to need two things. You're going to need a cornstarch and silicone caulk. A lot of the other videos will call for Dawn dishwashing soap and baby powder. It's just an extra step, an added expense, and you don't really need them. So let's talk about these ingredients real quick. We're going to need 16 ounces of cornstarch. This is from Walmart. It's a Walmart brand. This was 92 cents. And really any kind of a silicone caulk will work. This just happens to be the cheapest brand that Walmart sold. This is a Liquid Nails Indoor Outdoor Silicone Caulk. This is in a 10.1 ounce tube. I believe that's pretty standard. Just make sure you check it. So we're going to need about 10 ounces of the caulk and 16 ounces of the cornstarch. Now, before you get started, just a few precautions to take. You'll notice that I'm actually in my garage. The smell of this is pretty intense. You don't want to do this inside because you're going to want to do it in a well-ventilated area because it is a pretty powerful smell. It's going to stink up your house, and it can be pretty dangerous. Now, when you're working with this, make sure you read it. Make sure it's not something that you might end up being allergic to. If you are kind of sensitive to strong smells, you might want to pick up just a little painter's mask. I would normally wear this. I'm not going to wear it for the video today, just so you can hear me talk. And other than that, you might want to get some rubber gloves, because this stuff can get pretty messy. Let's get started. So the first thing we're going to want to do, just take a little bit of our cornstarch. Just going to spread it on our table. Just get that just a nice layer down. That's going to keep everything from sticking later. Okay. Gonna take our disposable tub. And we're going to pour about a third of this in there. Okay, that's about a third. Go ahead and cut our silicone open. We're just going to go ahead and cut the whole stem off. This particular brand doesn't, but some brands you buy might have a membrane on the inside. That's where you would take the either a nail, or a lot of your caulking guns will have this little nail on the end to break that membrane so you could actually get the silicone out. This one doesn't have it. We're just going to empty the whole 10 ounces into our tub. Okay, we're going to take about another third of this 16 ounces, put it on top. Okay, for now, we're just gonna mix it up with our popsicle sticks. This is when the smell really starts to get to you. As you can see, it's pretty messy. So you're gonna wanna do this definitely outdoors, if not for the mess, then definitely for the smell. Okay, and that's about all we can do with the popsicle sticks. It's not really binding together all that well at this point, so we're gonna have to get in there with our hands and knead it together. That's where you add the rest of the cornstarch. We're gonna keep just a little bit in there just to coat my rolling pin here in a few. Okay, that's about all we can do in the tubs. Now we're just going to dump it out on the table. Just knead it together. This is where the rubber gloves would definitely come in handy. Some of the excess. Okay, we're about ready to roll it out. It's about the consistency of bread dough. I don't know how well you can see it in the video, but it's about what I would compare it to. Okay, take our rolling pin. Last little bit of cornstarch. We're gonna put some on the top. Just to keep it from sticking. Keep my table from moving on me. There we go. If you notice it's starting to stick on you a little bit, you can add a little bit more cornstarch to the top. It's not going to hurt it. Okay, we've got that rolled out. Okay, we got it rolled out. It's about a half inch thick. Now we're ready to add the thing that we want to embed. You can do anything small, Legos, jewels. This particular time, we're just going to do Fruit Loops again. really just as simple as mashing them in. You want to do it for this particular embed, you're going to want to do it about a half inch thick. Something bigger like Legos, you might want to go a little bit thicker, just so you can get the whole thing in there without pushing it all the way through to the bottom. As you can see, it's nice and pliable. The Froot Loops go right in without breaking. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do for the video. You can fill the whole thing up. Definitely get your money's worth. If you wanted to neaten up now, now would be the time. Just go ahead and take your knife. Just while it's wet like this, it's going to stick, but once it dries, you'll be able to peel that right off. Okay, that's good enough for now. Basically looks just like a mold that you would buy in the store. We're gonna let this sit. Drying time is gonna vary quite a bit. Right now it's about 50 degrees outside. A lot of humidity, it's raining today, so it's gonna take this a bit to dry. In the summertime, where it's real hot and humid and dry, this is gonna dry a lot quicker. Okay, so this took about a half an hour to dry. Like I said, depending on the weather conditions, it could be more, could be less. But as you can see, it's set up nicely. It's nice and firm, yet still pliable enough to work with. The embeds just pop right out. And we're left with a nice mold. I'll go over the ingredients here again in just a second. I just checked the receipt. The cornstarch was 92 cents and the silicone that I bought was $3.77. So for something that somebody wanted to charge me $30 online for, I made myself for $4.69. We just had the 16 ounce Walmart brand cornstarch. Any brand will work, just make sure it's 16 ounces. And the 10 ounces of silicone mold. Like I said, any brand will work. This just happens to be the cheapest that they sold. Why spend any more than you have to? One thing to keep in mind, this is toxic. So this mold is gonna be used for candles only. If you're making this for bath products, probably wouldn't be an issue, but there could be a chance that some of this might leach into the soap or whatever you happen to be making, so you don't want to introduce that to somebody's body just in case there were any issues with it. Just save yourself that headache. So candles only, awesome mold. I said, this was something very similar to this, was $30. We made it ourselves for $4.69 and about 40 minutes worth of our time. So it's definitely worth it. I hope this video helped. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks, y'all.